Hello, everyone, and welcome to career number two, an NPC plays dad games. Again, as always, pretty much, I'm your pilot, NPC, and today we're going to be starting a new campaign with our new pilot, Robert Cross. We'll see how long he lasts, hopefully longer than Teddy Bishop did. Two episodes is not that great, but we'll see if we can't do better. So this time around, as you can see in the background here, I'm going to try and start my career as early in the war as I possibly can with the Nieuport 11. My pilot is technically American by what the campaign generator says. In fact, here, I'll just jump over to the campaign generator now. Robert Cross, you see here, on the unfortunately the remains of Teddy Bishop as well. So here we go. This is the roster. Mr. Corporal Robert Cross down at the bottom here. Zero everything because we just started. We're starting on January 1st, 1916 in our trusty Nieuport 11, a part of the 31st Escadrille stationed in Lemez? I'm going to go with Lemez. If anyone actually knows how to pronounce that, please feel free to correct me. Well, I'm actually going to try and do something a little bit fun this time around. I went into the config file and I changed some of the names of the pilots here. Only the last names. So Cad, Daribu, and B that you see here are all, kind of call signs of people and friends that I have in real life. And, I just thought it'd be kind of fun to put their names in there and see how long they last as AI pilots. And maybe even if we're lucky, we would even be able to do like a co-op mission to actually have one of them come and drop in and actually take the spot of their pilot for a mission and see if they actually live and if their skills is better or worse than the actual AI pilot that they've been assigned. So I've kept my settings pretty much exactly the same. If I go into advanced stuff, you can see here I had changed those two things I normally change just to make sure that I can actually die for starters, and that I'm only credited for zero extra every time, and so that I don't, you know, I only get one mission every time I do a mission instead of two, because I think it's really annoying kind of how they credit me for two missions instead of one. I think it's just a bug, but whatever, it's not that big a deal. It's pretty easy to change. Simple stuff I kept mostly the same. Low density all around. It kind of keeps things on average, on par, I guess, with all of each other. So we don't need to go through our entire roster of people. That's a bit silly. Mission. Let's get ourselves a mission. Oh, jeez. Okay, that's a bit of a long mission. Okay, well, whatever. We'll do it anyway. Let's go pilot selection to see if we... Man, we don't want these jerks in here. Let's fend out both two of those guys here, and let's put in Cad and Daribu. Let's see how they do on their first mission. Technically, I guess they're lower ranked than the guys we just booted out of there, but whatever. I'm the lowest of them all, so I'll have to surpass them eventually. Okay, so that all looks good. We got our everything. 3:30. Awesome. This is actually quite a long flight, so let's have our 100% fuel. We'll go accept. And now we'll jump back over to Rise of Flight here. Mission. Robert Cross. Go. Alright, here we are looking at the campaign map. We see our mission ahead of us, just like it was shown in the campaign generator. So, yeah, nothing too fancy here. Looks like we head a little bit southeast, then we go northwest, then we go east, then we go south, then we head back west to land. We'll take a quick look see at our plane. You can see I did put on the what was told to me by the thing was the 31st Escadrille's logo, squadron logo, default logo thingy, which is the little bow guy, which is kind of cool. I like that. I might do my own custom one later for me and possibly the other friends that I have, the other friend AI pilots that I have. Just go back to mission, and we'll just get this puppy started. Okay, let's go P. Center up track IR. Actually, hold on, give me one second. Having slight technical difficulties with track IR, but should be remedied momentarily. Oh, that popped up. That always pops up for some reason. There we go, perfect. Okay. So, looks like all the stuff in here is pretty basic. Let's start our engine at least. Put our mixture to full. We don't have a radiator because this is a... A little bit of a sputter there. Come on. Check our surfaces real quick. Am I getting left behind? I think I forgot to throttle up. Put a bit of throttle into it when I, come on, start. Okay, we got no time for fooling around. We gotta take off immediately. And we are in the air. I have almost pretty much never flown this plane before, so this should be an interesting event. I've also made a slight adjustment to my rudder pedals, so we'll have to see how that affects our flight. Lean out our mixture here to get some extra power. Man, they're way ahead of us now. We'll have to catch up to them. I know their flight path, so where's our compass, actually? Now that I think about it, I don't know where it is. Oh, I should pay attention. Okay, so I don't have a compass in this puppy. I have no idea what direction I'm facing. This is not looking good. I have really botched this takeoff. That is for sure. Well, this is a little bit disappointing. I seem to have lost my squadron in the... Oh, no, wait, there they are. Yes! Awesome. Well, I found them. It's a good thing, at least. At least I can go meet up with them and... possibly actually fly this mission. It's a little bit disappointing that I don't have a compass. A little weird, too. I'm not sure how I'm supposed to tell the directions now. I suppose I could use the sun, but I don't know if Rise of Flight does that kind of thing accurately. This isn't Arma. Anyhow, I'll cut the video here for you guys, and I will bring you guys back in once I either meet up with my squad or something interesting happens. This is quite the long patrol, so there's plenty of time for things to happen. See you in a bit. Just bringing you guys back in here for a quick moment. I think we headed north across the lines. As you can see, I met up with my squad again, which is kind of great. And look at all sorts of close at them. Oh, looks like the lead is banking. To what? I don't know, but just thought I'd bring you guys back in. let you know where we're at. I think, you know, I'm actually thinking maybe we didn't head in the direction I thought we did. I think that we may have headed east. I think we may have headed east, and then we're actually going to be going... Yeah, that actually makes more sense. Now we're about to head north. And then, from then on, we're going to head way back. Take a big, big leap across no man's land there. See the symbol on the side of... That's probably... I don't even know who that is. Probably either Derby or Cad. I should give them their own custom skins. That'd actually be kind of cool. I'll be able to identify them in mid-flight. I did give them the 31st squadron skin, but not quite the same as them having their own. So far there's been no action. We're pretty deep into enemy territory right now, though. If I look down, you can see the nice frozen land that is France in January. I did see a few airfields down there, although it doesn't seem like any of the Yastas want to come up and play with us. At least not at the moment, anyway. I kind of hope they do, considering they'll be flying Fokker E3s, and I'm fairly confident that I can take down at least one, maybe two Fokker E3s. These Nieuports are actually pretty maneuverable from what I hear. I've never actually really flown one myself, and I can tell you right now, from my last campaign in the DH2, this thing is a lot twitchier, which, you know, probably is not a bad thing. Makes it a different feel. Although I do find it strange that there's no compass in here. Makes it very difficult to fly or to navigate. If anybody knows why that is, or maybe if there is a compass and I'm just missing it, please let me know, because I would love to be able to know where I'm going. Maybe is that it? No, it looks like a fuel cap. Maybe one of these days I'll figure that out. There's gotta be a compass on here someplace. I was checking the wings just a second ago there, just to see if that's maybe where it was, but... So, if you look at the side of my seat, on either side, there are ammo drums, but of course, ammo drums are not compasses, contrary to popular belief. Well, anyhow, I thought I'd just bring you guys back in, give you a quick update. I'm going to cut the video here once again, because this is all just boring flight, and want to bring you back in. Hopefully something more interesting will be happening. See you in a bit. Okay, I'm bringing everybody back in right now, because it seems that our lead has turned to engage some planes. Those are Fokker E3s, yeah. Sorry, I had my thoughts mixed up there for a moment. They're definitely E3s. They don't seem to be doing anything, though. Oh, here they go. Let's bring it into action now. Okay, let's do this. Let's try and mark our first aerial kill with the Fokker E3. Put some throttle in. Use a little blip switch. Well, this isn't actually very good at all. Try and scissor them a little bit. See if that helps. And getting used to this Nieuport, it's actually more difficult than I thought it would be. Lean out the mixture more. Try and get that extra power. Thought I heard somebody above me. Oh man. That E3 just lost his own wing. Alright, lesson learned. Mr. E3s, don't be pulling some sick ass maneuvers if you can't keep your wings on. Now you're dead. And don't you feel silly. Alright, I see some more action flying around over here. Gotta say, the white ground can sometimes make it a little bit difficult to actually see. What are you? You're a Nieuport, I think, yeah. Okay. I'm actually not seeing any more E3s. Looking around here. Okay, well, way back there we have a fellow Nieuport. So at the very least, let's stick with him. So we can at least stay with our squad. It's a little unfortunate, no kills there. But man, the Nieuport's actually quite a bit more touchy than I expected it to be. Oh, there's another Nieuport down there by the looks of it. Okay. That might be the flight lead. Let's see if we can't pick out a streamer. Maybe that isn't a Nieuport. No, wait, it looks like it is. I think that is the lead. Maybe I'll fly past this guy. I just want to take a look. Oh well. Judging by the logo on the side of this plane here, that is at least either... Whoa, whoa, that's an Eindecker on your tail there. Turning to engage. I think what ended up happening there is that the lead got wounded and is heading back to base, and the others are following him and didn't pay attention to the fact that this Eindecker was right on their tail. Come on. Bit of a gun jam there. Getting some decent hits in. Guns out of ammo, damn it. Okay. Loading it. Retreating into the sun. Clever girl. But I've hit him really hard, so. Low speed flying. I think he's probably going down. Oh, he landed. Nice. Good on him, I guess. I'll let him go. I won't come around to try and shoot at him. But now, thanks to my little detour, I appear to have lost my squad. Worth it. I'm claiming that as a victory. He may not be dead, but he's pretty sufficiently wounded. I sure hope the flak doesn't catch me again this time. I'm pretty bad for that. Following off with one enemy and then ended up getting taken out by a flak. That's kind of my thing. For any of you who watched my Teddy Bishop thing, how many drums of ammo do I have left? I have one more left, plus the one I got up there. So I do have some ammo left. Another flak bursts. I'm pretty sure I'm headed back to the way I'm supposed to be going. Flak does not seem to be targeting me, which is rather nice. I'm really hoping to catch a visual on one of my squad mates. I know I went on quite the detour there for a bit, so they're probably a ways away. I do see quite a lot of flak going off in the middle of no man's land here, which kind of leads me to believe that perhaps something's going on, but it doesn't really seem to be concentrated anywhere in particular. It just sort of seems to be all over the place. This doesn't seem to be aimed at me, and that's what's most important. keep make sure I change direction every now and then to make sure that the flak doesn't catch me. I really don't want that to happen again. That would be really, really lame if I ended up getting shot down in my first episode. Second is lame enough, but first episode, that would be pitiful. Separated from my squadron once again. Sure wish I could spot them. I'm fairly confident that I know where I am, but even still, it's I don't think I have a compass in this thing, which is going to make navigation home rather difficult. If I had to take an educated guess, I would... I know I'm going over No Man's Land, and I think I'm headed west right now. Okay, well, I'm gonna cut the video here, and I'll bring you guys back when I think that anything has changed, or if I meet up with my squadron, or whatever ends up happening. We'll hope I don't get tagged by flak this time around, but you never know. I'll see you guys in a bit. Okay, bringing you guys back in ever so momentarily. I've clearly lost my squadron, and I have no idea where they went, so I've managed to figure out where I was, though, which is kind of nice. That town over there is Verdun. Which is a famous place. I don't know what for. I'm pretty sure probably a famous battle of some sort, but I know I've heard the name before, and which makes it famous in my book. So, from there, even though I don't have a compass, which is dumb, I should be able to find my way back. And I think that that's probably the best idea right now, considering I have no idea where my squadron is. And I, whoop, oh man, am going to crash this plane if I don't watch where the heck I'm going. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to follow this river here, which goes south of Verdun, and I'm going to follow this river until I get to my airfield, because there should be a small town. That's actually it right there. Okay, once I get to that town, if I turn and head pretty much straight west, I should run into my airfield. I should. Am I guaranteeing anything? Of course not. But I'm fairly sure that that's there. Because that pretty much has been matching everything I've seen so far. Which means it's on the other side of those trees. It's a little break through the trees. I'll try and follow that. Once I pass over this town here, I'll turn. Just so that I keep my bearings. There's a river over that way, which should be helpful in navigating where it is. It's right near the end of the river by the looks of it. So, I'm gonna start my banking. Start my turn here. Hopefully this will take me home. That would be swell. Just make sure I keep my sun relatively in view, just to my left-hand side, and that should be good for my navigation purposes. I've been using the sun a lot, actually, for my navigation, so it's actually proven to be quite useful. Alright, well, same as before, guys. I'm gonna cut the video here. I'll bring you guys back when I think I'm closer to the airfield. See you in a bit. All right, bringing everybody back in. I think I did it, actually. This fits the description of the map. You know, little river with an outcropping a bit to the left. I'm coming at it from the south, if you look at my map on the bottom there. So I'm pretty sure that that's Lemay's right there. Lemay's, and this is my airfield right there. I'm pretty sure of it. So what I'll do is I'll buzz over top of it, I'll check the wind direction, and I'll make my landing. Pulling back on the throttle here. I'll come in slower. I think I might need to adjust the response for my Nieuport a bit here, because it seems to always want to pull up. And I know that a lot of the World War I planes want to do that, but I have fixed that for basically all aircraft, so I would like to change it so that that is not the case. Okay, so it looks like the wind is coming from this. It's blowing this direction, which means this is the direction I want to approach from. So just I'll turn, break away. It's just I think it's, oopsie, wrong one. Wrong button. I think that's the color I need that indicates landing. I think it's white. Coming in on final here, let's turn the map off. I don't really need it anymore. Let's not put this thing in the dirt. Okay, a bit of a roll out there, but it looks to be okay. We haven't damaged anything by the looks of it. I'm gonna call it a successful thing. Take a look at that. Looks like my wheel's kind of dug into the ground a little bit there, but the plane itself seems okay. Excellent. Now let's check to see where everybody else is, because it'd be nice to know. Okay, so this is somebody, either Drew, Darabu, or Cad. This is also Darabu or Cad. They seem to be the only two left. Did we lose our lead? I wonder how far away they are. Oh man, by the looks of it, they continued on with the mission. You brave souls, you. Well, I'm gonna cut here, and I'm gonna wait. I'm going to fast forward time, and I'm going to wait until these guys actually get back to base, and then we'll see their landing. See you in a bit. Well, bringing everybody back in right now. I've followed our friends here as they've been heading back, and they're basically circling over the airfield right now, which is a little bit weird. If you look closely, you can see me parked in the middle of the airfield there. Ha ha ha. I can't actually move out of the way right now. At least I don't want to. They don't seem to be wanting to land for some reason, so screw them. I'm just going to go back to quietness. Me in the pilot seat. So I can see them. See them all the way up there. Look at that. Damn with them, though. So I'm going to go finish flight. Wait. Oh yeah, finish flight. I'm going to cover the screen with my hand, so that I can only see the corner. This is what I do whenever I complete missions. I'll proceed. I'll close out of this sucker. And then we will go back over to Pat Wilson's campaign generator. Back to campaign. Combat report. So I'm going to claim one victory there, because I think I got one. Fucker E3. Submit report. And we'll start the debrief. Okay, so we flew... Wow, God, yeah, okay. Gun caravan? Something destroyed? What? Did something attack ground targets without us ever knowing? Okay, so fucker E3 destroyed. Yeah, okay, so one got destroyed randomly. Aww. Ferdinand, our squadron leader in this case, got destroyed. That's pretty shitty, actually. The fucker E3 damaged by me? Cool. Destroyed by me? Also cool. Which means that we get the kill. And we go debriefing complete. Oh man, it didn't show everything else from everybody else, but man, Daribu got himself a kill. That jerk. I'll have to let him know. He'll probably be pretty pleased that his AI self has managed to get a kill. He's not exactly all that great at these atmospheric type games. He's more of a space sim kind of guy, so he might be a little happy to see that. Go back to the scoreboard here just for a quick update before we end the episode for the night. So, Corporal Robert Cross got one kill on his first mission. This bodes well, although maybe saying that is probably not the best thing to do, considering Teddy Bishop did the same, and we all saw how long he lasted. Daribu bagged himself a kill, which is pretty cool, as well as one extra mission. I don't know how he's the same rank as Mr. Pierre Cad here, but Cad didn't come home with any missions, and unfortunately, we lost our faithful captain. Don't know why he's still on here, actually. I guess that's that. And yeah, with that, I hope everyone tunes in next time for the second episode of my second career, and hopefully this career will actually be able to go on for a long period of time. Hopefully Robert Cross will be the one and we can keep going with this to the point where maybe even get a Nieuport 17, maybe further. That'd be kind of neat. I hope to play, continue this campaign for as long as I possibly can, just like I did with the Teddy Bishop campaign, and this time, we'll be very wary of flak. Thanks for watching, and hope to see everybody next time.